Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Josh, and today we're talking about aperture. So I'll start with a really basic explanation. Aperture is a measure of how much light passes through here, your lens, and it determines how shallow your depth of field is in your shots. So then you can have awesome Instagram headshots with a blurred out background. Just like all your cool friends with the new iPhone 7. Okay, so that's the quick version, but let me break it down for you a little more. So inside your lens is an opening called an iris that light enters through to land on your camera's image sensor, ultimately to make an image, whether that be a picture or a video. Aperture is the size of this opening. So the bigger the opening, the more light that passes through your lens and the more exposed your image will be. The smaller the opening, the less light. Makes sense, right? But it also determines depth of field, like I mentioned. So a higher aperture has a more shallow depth of field, where only a specific part of the image is in focus, making it great for portraits of this bro and your cliche cup of coffee. A low aperture you'll use for pretty landscape shots and any images where you want everything in focus. So here's the confusing part. Aperture values are described by f-stops. An f-stop is the ratio of the opening of a lens aperture when compared to the size of the lens. What can be confusing here is that a higher f-stop is actually described by a lower number. So f1.4 will give you an image like this, whereas f22 will give you an image like this. Well, that's all I've got for you. I hope you learned something new, because learning is important. I'll leave you with this inspirational quote. If you have any other questions, let me know in the comments or contact me here. Thanks, bye.